send one in. I'll post it on YouTube.
Or Monday, or whatever.
Whenever it happens, you just have to
Yeah, keep an eye on how things are moving.
That's the main way. Funny, give me that.
The master.
Can I make a copy on it?
Well, you can take that. I'll make a copy.
No, no. Okay, no.
Laura brought that. Let her know about that. Okay. We'll see on Saturday. If there's any questions, you have a phone number in the L. Okay. Give a call.
And you can pick up the phone.
10 o'clock. Also, as you can see, all food concession will be able to view and hear the concert without much difficulty.
Thank you. Hi, who are you, and could you tell us a little about what this is all about?
Well, I'm Rick Gilson. I'm managing the food concession here, and what we're trying to do is put out a lot of decent food for a lot of people. We're planning on 5,000 people coming here. We're serving potato salad and coleslaw, hot dogs, fruit drinks. We have vegetarian food for people that are not into meat. We have chicken, tacos, burgers, dogs, ice cream. And we got it pretty well dispersed, and hopefully with a nice day like today, we're going to sell it all.
Your prices seem fairly reasonable. What's the highest item here on the menu?
I believe right now it looks like chicken breast for $1.75. And we realize we have a corner on the market, but we're also trying to keep our prices down. You know, this is a day for people to enjoy themselves, not go broke. And that's been our theory behind it.
You have several other stands over here. What are you selling next?
We're selling steamed hot dogs at one. We have natural fruit juice at the other. And we also have ice cream for the ice cream fans, and just the normal munch-out food for the day. And we're going to be serving from 12 to 7 tonight. And everybody here is pretty dedicated, and we're organized.
Sounds excellent. How many people do you have working for you here?
Offhand, about 25, and we're breaking people during the middle of the day so they can watch the show.
Dynamite. Neil, I understand this is your mobile first aid station. Could you tell me a little about it, please?
Yeah, it's fully equipped as an emergency room. You can take care of any public event, fairgrounds, or anything of this nature. We do a lot of fairgrounds, and we have done several concerts for the U.R. It's something we set up because we can handle most all the things that happen at a concert right here. We don't have to transport through traffic and cause a lot of problems for people.
What sort of apparatus do you have here in case of emergencies?
Well, today we have two animal crews, and we have the mobile first aid room. It's all equipped with suction and oxygen and all the things that we would need to save a life. We have five people on staff here today, so I think we're well equipped to take care of the situation.
These are your two staff members here. What are your names, please, gentlemen?
Rick Powell.
And what do you do?
Well, I'm driving today.
Just help out ordinarily?
Well, I've worked for Neil almost 5 years now, and I do a lot of the driving.
And your name, sir, please?
My name is John Curtis.
And I noticed you have a camera here. Are you excited about this concert?
Yeah, a little bit. I came here mostly to work along with Rick and Mr. Hurd, and it's kind of slow to take a few pictures of the facility. I kind of like to keep track of the different events that we've had.
Well, you gentlemen are very evident. It's very good. Things look to be okay, hey?
I think it's going to be a very good day. It looks good. It's well planned. It's probably one of the best events I've ever worked.
Excellent. Thank you. Why are you all up here? Just for anyone in particular? You work for this concert?
Yeah, I play with John Lincoln Wright Band.
Oh, I see. And he's just visiting? Right. Oh, excellent. You guys look very comfortable.
Yeah, really?
Definitely.
Myself.
So how long do you think you'll be staying here?
Most of the afternoon, I guess.
You excited about it?
Well, I like playing. Yeah, I haven't been able to play in a few days because I've been ill. So it's always nice to come back and play, especially outside.
What do you think about the setup? Does it look good?
Yeah, it looks like a great place to play. I hope a lot of people come because it's a beautiful place to have an outdoor concert. The last one that we played at was all dirt, you know, and it was horrible. It was like sitting in a dust bowl. But this is really nice. It's all grass.
What do you think about the way things have been set up by the Soma Productions here?
Well, it seems great. I don't know that much about them, but I know that they got a great sound system. I mean, the last time we worked with Timber Audio, they did a real good job for us, and I really like them. So, you know, if you have anything to do with that, more power to you.
Thank you very much. Could you tell me your name and the name of the band?
It's the John Lincoln Wright Band. I'm John Lincoln Wright.
Hi, how you doing? Where do you usually play?
We play all over, mostly around New England, the Northeast, from, say, New York City north to Bangor, Maine. That's basically our circuit. A lot of work around Massachusetts. We're based out of Boston and Cambridge, around that area. And we do a lot of work in Maine, a little bit in New Hampshire.
How did you end up getting over here to play?
An agent, you know, one of our agents called and had the date for us. I guess Soma Productions, I think most of the artists here came through, I think, the Athena agency, I think, and we do some work with them, and I would think possibly it came through that night.
You just finished playing, right?
We just got off, yeah, early in the day to play. But it was a lot of fun. It's a nice crowd, and it's a beautiful day.
How did it sound out there?
Out there, I don't know how it sounded. On stage, it sounded good. It seems to be a real good PA system. The sound quality seemed to be good. The monitors were great. One of the best monitors I've used for a show, because it's hard when you're singing all the songs and you can't hear yourself. It's tough. So I could hear myself fine, everybody else in the band, so it was good. Yeah.
Mark, why don't you tell me a little about what's going on here?
We're having a concert. The first of our series. Next one's August 12th at Canaan, New Hampshire, up at the fairgrounds up there. And working on the lineup right now. Hopefully, it looks like Arlo Guthrie, Dirt Band, Dillard's, and Newgrass Revival. And we're hoping things work out here and we'll have a real successful day and have another great concert next month.
Things seem to be going well. Is everything all right out back?
Yeah, pretty good. The crowd is real pleased with John, and I was real pleased with John. It sounded excellent out there. I heard John for the first time live in at a Claremont concert a month and a half ago, and I was impressed, and we got him here.
How many bands are playing here today?
There's five bands playing here today. Jonathan Edwards, Leon Redbone, Tom Rush, John Bassett, and John Lincoln Wright.
Sounds good. Sounds really good. Are you expecting a lot more people?
Yeah, we expect the people to be filtering in all day up until around 3, 4 o'clock, latecomers. 12 o'clock's an early start. And
this is going to last till when?
Oh, a little before dark. I'm trying to get the people out of here by dark. That was the arrangements with the town and the college. And
sounds good. Things seem to be very together here. You happy with it?
Oh, real happy. Real happy.
Thanks. Best plan we got. Hi, you want to tell me your name and what you're doing here?
Bruce Cattell, and I'm the staff photographer. I think that's what they told me I'm doing. I'm taking pictures of the show today.
For Soma Productions?
Soma Productions, that's the best way to go.
What do you think of this thing so far?
Well, it's nice. It's very mellow, you know? It's a good chance to lay back in the country.
How does the crowd seem to you?
Excited. I can't wait for Jonathan Edwards to come on. Can you wait? I mean, can you?
Oh, yes, definitely. I can wait. It seems like there's a lot of good people here. What do you think about it?
I like the people. The people are great. That's what's making this. That's what's happening here. The people are the best part of the whole thing.
And some productions?
I don't know. Do I know them? Am I supposed to know these people? Do you know these people? Do you know these people?
Okay. Hi, you want to tell me your name and what you do for some productions?
Lots of things.
Good. Hi.
I'm about to do MC.
Hey, I hope you all have a good time out there. Sure, it's beautiful weather. We're glad we got that. Yeah. Right now, I'd like to ask you to welcome all the way from Cleveland, Ohio, via American Airlines, luckily, Mr. John Bassett. Thank you, music lover. How you doing today? Did you have a good time getting here? Good. Nice ride. Yeah, you know. I was up till, I did a gig in Cleveland opening for Rick Havens last night. And finished up about 3 in the morning, and a friend of mine took me out to the airport and stayed at the show with him. And, I had to get up at 6:30 to get on the plane, you know, and get here. We got no volume on the guitar mic to start with, so I'll just talk to you a little bit until it happens. Ah, there it comes, there it comes. We're on time, good, all right.
Thank you.
Okay, yeah, I'll get it.
Great.
we can interview you now.
You can interview me right now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, excellent.
Great.
All right, how do you feel about after playing here now?
Wow, playing in New Hampshire, the gas in the summertime, sun shining and everything.
The crowd's excellent, huh?
No, I don't ski.
No, you don't ski. Fine, yes. How do you like New Hampshire?
It is a beautiful state. The mountains are mellow here, not like Colorado.
You live in Cleveland, don't you?
No, I do not live in Cleveland.
In Ohio?
Atwater.
Atwater.
Yeah.
Like New Hampshire?
A-T-W-H-T-O.
Okay, fine.
I'm sorry. I'm not real good on my figures this year.
I failed science in 10th grade.
You did? You failed science in 10th grade?
Right.
Oh, hey, I did okay with science in 10th grade. It was mathematics around about 7th grade that really got me. They throwed algebra on me and changed the whole system. It took me a long time to identify the fact that they were saying the same thing, only using symbols, different set of symbols, you know? And I flunked because I didn't know algebra. The rest was easy.
I understand you're giving out records here. Where can I buy them?
No.
Can I find one to buy one?
Yes, a consumer. All I have are books. You guys in color? Hey, watch that. Very subtle, so you can't see that there's a girl in there. She has an interesting face. I don't know.
What's the name of your album? I didn't catch that.
Oh, this is the John Who album. I'm all out of those. I'm working on a new album with a group of fellas. We call ourselves Attila and the Screaming Mongoloid.
I see.
Huh? No, how does Lloyds of London spell Lloyd? I got a piece of the rock. Can I get out of here now? Thank you very much. Talk to you later.
Thank you all for coming out here today. And thank God we had some nice weather. Yeah. I'd like to remind you that the concession's open until about 7 o'clock and there's lots of food over there. Chicken and for veggies like me, there's some vegetarian tacos for you too. Thanks again for coming. Right now I'd like to introduce the only man that got to walk to the concert today. New Hampshire's own Tom Rush.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. every kind. Roots from Larry Lenten.
We're rolling. Tom Rush. People. Look at the birdie right here.
First of all, let me ask you a very important question. Would you hold this?
Nah.
No, okay, we're going to put this up. Can I have a sip of that?
Sure.
Sure, I got cotton throat, man.
Okay. Who's this guy, anyway?
Nice. Listen, man, what's your name?
Hey, can you turn it on?
Excuse me. What?
Hey, we're all in it. We're going to be in the movie.
What's
We're all doing drugs today.
You don't have to hold it. You don't have to hold it.
I'm sorry.
No, you can just talk.
Yeah, I don't like it.
It's a very good man.
Ramble on, son.
Fellas, guys,
where are you from?
Channel 9.
No, where are you from? Are you from Manhattan?
We want to come over.
Stay right over here.
Hi, I guess you all know where we are, so I'm not going to ask you where we are.
Right.
Why don't you tell me what your names are? You first.
Debbie. Carol.
And Debbie.
Two Debbies in the camera.
Yeah.
So what do you think of this Soma production?
It's all right. Excellent.
Mm-hmm. What time did you get here this morning?
12.
Right.
I got here about 2. I had to work.
Oh, you had to work.
Yeah, I had to work too.
Where were you working?
Training
in
Cedarville.
Mm-hmm. So what
it's
do you
a good concert.
You guys like to do this every weekend?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Listen, Soma Productions is planning to have a concert in August in Canaan, New Hampshire.
Yeah, I read that on the ticket.
And it's going to be
oh,
at the,
yeah.
going to be at a fairground there, and I don't know who's playing myself right now.
Oh, God. We'll be on the radio.
Yeah, you'll hear about it for sure.
All right, yeah.
Okay?
Yeah. All right.
Thanks
all right.
a lot for stopping.
Yeah. Yeah. Thanks a lot.
Cut.
Hope it gets back.
I'm not exactly in an interviewing mood, so.
Now. like to bring on my lovely wife, Carolina, to join us on a song. Hi, Dress. Hi, Long Dress. This is a song, she allowed me to record this song we're going to do for you because she wrote it.
Down another county, I swear.
Hey, y'all, keep pretty good time.
Feel after playing here in Anthem today?
Tired is how it feels.
I had a good time.
Did you think you did well?
I had a good time. I think some people did, at least.
I understand you all have decided to stay here in New Hampshire. You like the countryside?
I grew up in New Hampshire, so I've moved back here after having lived in Boston, New York, and some different places. I moved back to Deering about 7 years ago, so Beverly's not from here, but...
Where are you from? I'm from all over. I came from Colorado. I love it here. It's my home. How does New Hampshire compare to Colorado?
It's much homier and warmer. I love it.
How long have you all been here?
5 years? I think it's 5 years.
5 years for you, 7 years for me.
You both enjoy it a lot, I guess.
Yeah. And I love watching the shutter move. Well, it's not a shutter, is it? The stuff with the F-stops on it, you know? Thank God we have a technician. This new Betamax is unique, to say the least. But her features are beyond my capacity to use words about. I've often sat and put an end piece on a tape, you know, watch the tape go around and around before, as it is, as it gets to the end. I think that's what I'm trying to say. can you...
One, two. Jack, one, two. Jack, one, two. Well,
no formality. Enough to me. I think we're down below battery level. I'm not a tech, I'm an assigned. This is Ted Antulo. Signing off here from another We Do Media production. Wait a minute. Oh yeah, this is important. I forgot to tell you about the possibility of making a major epic in the next 2 years. I think that the world is ready for something that is not going to be tacky, but is going to kind of bind together science and all the other kinds of knowledge.